So today we're going to settle the age-old debate, open cell versus closed cell. Well, we're not actually going to settle the debate, but I am going to talk about some pointers about open cell and closed cell, hopefully guide you in the right direction. At the end of the day, the simple answer is they both work. It's not that one's better than the other, but one may be more suitable for a specific application. Here are some broad strokes. If it's a house, if it's any type of residential project, we usually recommend open cell. One main reason is its high expansion rate. Anytime you have wood coming together, you're going to have a lot of gaps, a lot of nooks and crannies that need to be filled. Open cell is a lot better at that than closed cell, simply because of its higher expansion rate. And at the end of the day, you want to establish that building envelope so that you get that good air seal. Open cell is just simply better at that when you have a lot of gaps around your exterior. So something else to keep in mind is cost. Usually open cell is going to be a little less expensive than closed cell. So if you're building a new house or if you're remodeling an existing house, you're constantly looking at the different things, the framing cost, the roofing cost, excavation. And then you get onto the interior and start worrying about what kind of cabinets and such that you're going to put in. The whole time you're adding up dollars. Open cell is, like I said, usually less expensive than closed cell, so that could be another advantage for a residence. Now, application-wise, one area in particular is a roof deck. We usually recommend a ventless system in your attic, so a spray foam applied right to the roof deck. Now, in that case, open cell is more advantageous because water can pass through it under hydrostatic pressure. So if there's a roof leak, for example, what would happen is ultimately the water would slowly pass through the foam. The foam will look discolored and you'll know there's a roof leak right there. You can cut that out and fix the roof leak. Now, some people might say that's a bad thing because it comes through and the open cell doesn't stop the water. Well, the reason why that can potentially be bad if the water stopped, like if you use closed cell, and closed cell would be impenetrable through water. It would have to break the foam to really go through it. What can happen is if that water flows off to another area of the roof or some other area in the house and starts causing problems elsewhere. And you also have no idea where the leak started from. And we've seen this happen more than once. So that's one specific issue where closed cell could be a downside on a specific application, this time being a roof deck. Now, inversely, commercial projects and pole barns are usually better for closed cell spray foam. For example, exterior walls of a barn that are going to be left exposed, the durability and toughness of closed cell really comes into play there. If you're going to lean tools against it or potentially bump into the foam, it's not going to get damaged if it's closed cell. Or if it does, it's very, very minor and it's not going to damage the foam's ability to stop thermal transfer. Whereas if you use open cell, that can very easily get damaged quickly. It's very soft and pliable. It will get torn up if it's bumped into, and then you do start to lose some of that thermal difference ability. So again, that's one specific application where open cell does not have an advantage over closed cell. So at the end of the day, we usually recommend closed cell for pole barns and commercial projects and open cell for residential. Again, we've used both for different types of projects and they work. At the end of the day, both will work. And it's more important to find out the specific open cell or the specific closed cell that your contractor plans on using. I've said many, many times that every spray foam is different. And one thing that a lot of people knock down open cell for is they'll say it absorbs water. Well, the truth is there are several spray foam brands out there that their open cell does absorb water. I would always recommend to stay away from them. Now again, that's why I say it's important for you to talk to your contractor and know exactly what product that they're using. Know what that product does, know its capabilities and everything. The last point I want to touch on is R value. A lot of people steer towards closed cell because they say it has a higher R value. Well, to be honest, if that's really what you're basing this on, I think you should take a couple steps back and look at the more important things like an air seal in your building. If you're really leaning on a product simply because it has a higher R value, I think you're missing some of the other capabilities. R value at the end of the day is not as important of a piece in the puzzle that we thought it was years ago. Like I said, air seal is the more important piece. And both open cell and closed cell both establish an air seal. So as long as you're using a product that does that, you've already won most of the battle. So having a higher R value is not as important as some people may tell you it is. At the end of the day, both products, open cell and closed cell, have a very, very high thermal transfer stoppage. So you're really good either way as far as that goes. It's all the little things, like the pliability of open cell. On a house, again, in the future, if you want to add some wiring or change some plumbing, open cell is super easy to work with. Whereas closed cell, you need to break out some power tools and chisel some of that out. Those are all the little things that you're going to have to take into account and think down the road where one may be better than the other. Again, at the end of the day, usually open cell is best for a residence. Usually closed cell is best for a commercial project. It's really best to sit down with your contractor and make sure both you guys are on the same page and both of you understand exactly what they're putting in and make sure your expectations are all in line. Hope you found this information helpful. I hope we were able to guide you at least in the right path on this never-ending debate of open cell and closed cell. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, leave us a comment. If you have a question about open cell and closed cell, tell us. If you have a specific project coming up, we'd love to help guide you that way. Don't forget to hit the bell button so you get all of our notifications. If you guys have ever wondered what I'm holding during these videos, it's actually one of our guides, the ultimate guide to foam insulation. This one happens to be for existing homes. We also have one for pole barns, as well as one for new homes. These are also downloadable on our website. Check it out.